location. You walk in and there's a couch, little table, TV, fridge, toaster, microwave, kettle, and then this is the room. So, storage, more storage, dustpan and broom, bedside table, little bed, chest of drawers, table and a desk. Ooh. And shower and bathroom. I wonder what the view's like. If I can get this open. So this is my view from my bedroom. I'm already sweating, so right now at 1:45. We've been told that we have to go to work now, so need to get changed in form. And then freshen up a little bit, and then we're getting picked up to go to work. Hey guys, so day one is down. It's currently 7:30. Came back to the place. We popped into the shops quickly because colleagues wanted to get a few things at the shops and I didn't get anything. Every food's covered for, I've got clothes and everything, so I didn't really need to get anything. But I just went in and had a look, go for a little bit of a walk and just kind of see what the shopping center's like. It has a Boost, it's got a Kmart, a Coles, a pharmacy, a Bunbury's, a Things, an EB Games. That's pretty much all I saw, I think. But yeah, and then we came back to the place and I had dinner with one of the colleagues from Perth, and then I came into our room and I decided to go for a walk around the place. It was actually not too hot at that time. It was about 6 o'clock, just after 6, and there was a nice breeze and I just had a look at the sunset, and then I came into my room and watch the TV. There's no Wi-Fi here, so I've been messaging my family and kind of messaging my friends, but I don't want to use too much data because I'm here for weeks and I don't want to run out. So yeah, I have to find ways of entertaining myself. Luckily I bought books, but if I had known, I would have bought bigger books or maybe my journal or something. But anyways, what's done is done. And then I had a shower and watched some TV, as I said. And right now I'm just on my bed, chilling by myself in my room. I want to have an early night because last night I did not sleep well and we start work at 7:30 tomorrow. So I think we have to leave here 7. I need to have breakfast. I felt so ill today. Basically, we got off the plane around 1 o'clock and then they drove us to our accommodation and we had about 45 minutes to unpack, get settled, have a quick tour of the place. And then at 2:40, we had a workplace and did a little bit of work there just to help them out. So I didn't have lunch and I didn't eat a lot of breakfast. I had a little bit of food at the airport in Perth, like a hot chocolate and a quarter of a croissant thing. And then on the plane, just a little snack. Just like feeling low in energy, I started my cycle last night. So that's too much information. So I was up since 5 this morning with having cramps and stuff, so I'm grateful for the rest, but I don't know what I'm gonna do with myself for the next 2 weeks. Like, third world problems, there's no Wi-Fi, there's not really a lot to do around here, and obviously it's not safe to go around walking by myself at night, but I know for the next couple of days and next week as well, I'll probably be so tired because we're working 7:30 to 4. But I was kind of hoping that after work we could go to the beach or something and just chill, watch the sunset. But because I'm sharing a car with the other girls, I don't know what they're going to want to do. I know on the weekend they'll want to go exploring, but I'm not sure during the week, so I guess we'll have to play it by ear. And yeah, obviously not every day we have to go out, but it would be nice if we could go out after work, even just for a beach drive or a walk. We're just trying to like wrap my head around everything. I'm kind of glad we went to the center today just because I know kind of what it's like. Just chilling at the moment and then read for a bit and maybe go to bed at 9. Get up at 6 tomorrow. Or I'll message the other girls and see what time they want to leave tomorrow and then figure out how much time I need for breakfast and stuff. But yeah, I'll probably talk to you guys tomorrow and keep you guys updated. Good morning, guys. So it's 6:08 and I'm already ready with just my black uniform. This is what I have to wear for the company that I work for back in Perth. So I just presumed that this is what I had to wear here. But apparently we don't have to wear black as long as it's neat and tidy. But all my shorts and t-shirts have like patterns and stuff, so I might as well stick with what I have. Plus, this will protect me from the sun even though it's hot. The more skin I cover, the less sunscreen I have to put on, if you know what I mean. But anyways, I've put my hair up in a bun. I think it's gonna be 39 today. But yeah, I woke up at 5:55 and I'm already ready, so I have about under an hour before I have to go meet the girls in the car park to go to work. But I'm just gonna do a quick devotion and then go down to the dining room and have some breakfast. And yeah, 7:30 to 4 today. I don't know if that's the shift we're doing every day, but for today, that is what we're doing. And then I think the other girls want to go to the shop after work, probably to get some snacks. Sorry, there's all ants in my bathroom, and I feel like crawling all over me. I'll talk to you guys later. Swiss high strength vitamin C things that you put in your water. So I'm just gonna put one of them in now. Clearly I'm still half asleep. I think I'm good to go and get breakfast now. Hey guys, day two over. Well, officially day one, I'm gonna say, because yesterday I was driving and working for a little bit, but today was our first full day, but second day here. So we worked 7:30 to 4:30 today, and then we took a quick trip to the shops. I just got some strawberries and blueberries and some toilet paper, because apparently we have to provide our own toiletries and stuff, which I didn't realize until I got here. So the other girl from my same agency and I are sharing a pack of 12 each. After we went to the shops, we had dinner. Actually are planning a weekend trip to a national park about 3 hours, almost 4 hours drive away. Borrow a car, drive up there, and originally we were going to drive up early in the morning, look around, and then drive back in the night, but we underestimated how big the national park is and we want to see a lot, so we've decided we're going to stay the night there and then continue looking Sunday morning and then drive back and then rest in the afternoon and that for a little bit. And then I had a shower and now it's about 8 o'clock and I'm just watching some friends and chilling on my phone. I'm trying not to use too much data and spend a lot of time on my phone anyway, but quickly checking my messages and emails and stuff. But yeah, I might talk to my family soon just to give them a little bit of an update and chat, because I'm pretty bored out here and yeah, I just feel like having a chat. But I'll probably try to go to bed probably around 9:30, just because yesterday it took me a while to get to sleep. First I had the fan on, it was too loud, then I turned the aircon on. Just usually the first night is always a bit unsettling and I had a lot on my mind, but pretty tough. It was 39 today, so Thankfully, we didn't spend a lot of time outside. We spent probably the first hour and a half in the morning that I was there outside, and then we went inside until the last hour and a half again. Yeah, it's very dangerous to be outside in this heat for sunburn. I've been there for a full day today. I kind of have a bit more of an idea of what to expect. So yeah, I don't know if that's a good or a bad thing because it was quite full on today. But yeah, I think tomorrow's not going to be as hot, maybe 36 tomorrow, I think. We'll see how that goes. Guys, so it is now 20 to 9. We got back to the accommodation at about 7:15, and then I had a shower, washed my hair, and I've just been in bed watching Tangled Before Ever After. I know that sounds so childish on Disney Plus, so it was just under an hour, so I just finished watching that. I'm just gonna maybe read for 20 to 30 minutes and then try and go to sleep, because I've noticed it takes me a while to fall asleep and stuff, and then I'm not getting enough sleep and I'm waking up and just being really tired during the day. I was struggling so much because I was so tired, like lack of sleep and like the heat and everything really drains you. Today was a good day. We did some activities today which helped like keep the kids occupied and help the day kind of go a little bit faster. Today after work we had to drive in town to run a few errands for the other stuff. Then we came back and had dinner, and then we went out again to Kmart, got some stuff for the weekend trip, like the other girls got snacks, and we got lots of water and Powerade because it's gonna be very, very hot, and it's just keeping me going to the weekend. Two more days to go, and then we can have some fun. I feel like I've been here for so long, but I've only been here for 2 full days. It's hard work. And myself, like, she asked me to stay another week, I'll probably say yes. Partly because I feel like one weekend isn't really enough. This weekend we're going on a road trip. I don't get asked to stay longer. I'll be leaving next Friday, so I don't have a lot of time to look around. If you think about hours after work, by the time we finish work it's 4:30, close to 5, and then we come back, have dinner and have showers and like knackered. My point is that even though the work is hard, it's a good way to save money because I really don't have any expenses out here. I mean, today I bought more sunscreen because I need more, but pretty much everything is covered for. It's constant work because at least I'm going to the same center. When I was back home, work every day, but it would be a different place every day. And it was really stressful waking up in the morning, trying to figure out where I was going to go. Routine in terms of where I'm going and hours, and I'm with other people, so that makes me feel a lot better. But anyways, I'm rambling now. My point is that if they asked me to stay another week, I would, because originally they said I was going to come for 3 weeks and then it could change to 2 weeks. So see how it goes. She hasn't said anything to me yet, but still early days. So yeah, I've just wasted like 5 minutes of my reading time talking, but anyways, I thought I would give you guys an update. Obviously, I can't really film a lot because we're going to work all day. Tomorrow we're going out for dinner. But yeah, I'm gonna get ready for bed now and I'll talk to you guys tomorrow. So it's like 6:20. I don't know why, but every night, no matter how much sleep I try and get, I'm still so tired when I wake up. I tried going to sleep at 15. I thought I would have had enough sleep, but I still feel so tired. But maybe some food wake me up a bit, but 2 more days And then it's a weekend. So it's just past six and I'm getting ready. I'm just wearing this off the shoulder knee slit dress from Ali to dinner. It's still like a casually type dress and keep me cool because of the slits, but there's always air con. So, and I've just got a blue scrunch in my hair because it's too hot to have it out. At 6:45, I already had dinner in the dining hall because I'm just so hungry. I can't wait till past seven to eat, and also I don't want to spend a lot of money out here. I might just get something small to eat. We'll see how I go. Yeah, I just needed some comfort food, so we had pasta with pesto chicken. But yeah, today was probably one of the hardest days out of all of them. But they have offered me to stay a week longer, so I said yes to staying a week longer and she said four. But I think it'd just be too much for me because my friend's having an engagement party and she's saying it's okay if I miss it, but I'm already feeling homesick for my family and just I feel it's quite lonely out here. I think 3 weeks will be enough and then I need a break, and then if they want me to come back, I'll consider coming back, but not a full-time position just yet. I kind of just need to figure out what I'm doing next year and really think about it. One of the other girls was telling me about what we get if we had to permanently work up here. I much prefer EA work though, so I'll see how I go. But anyways, yeah, I'm gonna stay for another week, which means that I get an extra weekend to look around, which is what I wanted. And obviously to save more money. We did a Target run after work because some of the girls needed to get some stuff. So we got more water for our trip, and I just got money out to pay back the girl because she paid for the accommodation and bought us some water already. Found out it's gonna be really, really, really hot. Like it's in the 40s, maybe even 50s. So I'm a bit worried. I just pray that like we're safe and nothing happens. I will chat to you guys later, if not tomorrow.
I don't know if I can take
tomorrow.
I didn't call you back, my fault. Some days I don't talk at all, and some days I'm just not in the mood.
There's the moon. Alright, it's 9:30. I've just been on the computer for probably 30 to 40 minutes. Oops. But I really need to go and get some sleep now and have a quick shower. After a full week of work. Oh. Okay, so it's 6:30. I've just heated up my meal in my room because it's taking too long for my friend to heat up hers in the dining room. And this took forever as well to do for us. So it's just butter chicken, leftovers, Friday and the weekend. We just have leftovers because he doesn't come and cook. I'm just watching TV, waiting for my washing to be done, and then I'll hang that out and need to pack my bag for the weekend. Yay, happy Friday. It's currently 8:30. Just had a shower and I'm cleaning my face. In the meantime, I'm going to blow up this inflatable that I bought at Kmart. I also bought sunglasses because I think I left mine at the center. And this is for our road trip because we saw in lots of photos that people bought these, and also just to help us because apparently the water is quite deep. I'm going to blow up at least half of it so that I don't have to spend so much time blowing it up when we get there tomorrow. But yeah, I've hung out my washing, pretty much done everything. Bags in the car. Tomorrow I'll just get this and the food that's in the fridge and my wallet and minute things. I decided I'm going to wear my bathers there just because it's easier than getting change there and then just put a dress over it. I'm going to get up at 3:15, I think, just in case. We are going to get like 3:30-ish and then meet at 3:45 to have breakfast, but I feel like 15 minutes isn't really enough for me to have breakfast, so I'm going to get up at 3:15 because I need to quickly take my clothes off the line. I don't want to leave them hanging out there all weekend. Get changed, have breakfast. But yeah, today was a pretty good day at work actually because I got to help one of the other girls organize the room. So we reorganized it. We made a construction corner, home corner, book corner, quiet corner with puzzles and activities. So we're trying to ramp it up for next week, which is exciting. So I didn't really spend a lot of time with the kids, just a bit in the morning and the afternoon. Yeah, I'm a little bit nervous. Hope that everything goes well. So I've asked people to pray for us and hopefully everything goes well. I know God is on our side, but it's just nerve-wracking because we're going to a place that we've never been to. It's out in the middle of nowhere and so many things can happen. And I'm not the best swimmer as well, and I get a little bit scared if I have to climb somewhere and what if I can't get out. So I know that I am a very anxious person and I probably worry way too much and I overthink things. But yeah, I should probably quickly go blow this up, and then I need to get some sleep because we have a big day tomorrow. So I will catch you guys on the other side tomorrow when we're up at the crack of dawn, before the crack of dawn, to go to Karen Genie. So excited.